Mount Lushan, with its misty peaks and wooded slopes, has traditionally been a place where people go to escape from the summer heat on the lower reaches of the Yangtze. In the 1930s and 40s, among the regular visitors to Mount Lushan were one very famous couple.
In 1975, Chiang Kai-shek died in Taiwan at the age of 88. In his last years, Chiang had been in the habit of gazing at the mainland through a telescope. He was looking for somewhere to be his last resting place. Eventually, he selected three possible sites. Nanjing, capital of Jiangsu Province, the town of Xikou in Zhejiang Province, and Mount Lushan in Jiangxi Province. Nanjing had been the national capital when the Kuomintang ruled China before 1949, and Xikou was Chiang's hometown. But why Mount Lushan? What was the link between the mountain and the Kuomintang leader? In 1992, plans were announced to auction 50-year leases on 21 villas on Mount Lushan. When the news reached New York's Locust Valley, it greatly worried a 95-year-old lady. She was Song Mei Ling, or Madam Chiang Kai-shek. She had spent 20 years living in one of the villas on the mountain. Her worries were eased when she learned that her villa, the famous Mei Lu Villa, was excluded from the auction. Mei Lu Villa, having served as the residence of two great figures in history, Mao Zedong and Chiang Kai-shek, is a silent witness to a bygone era. The villa, unlike the others on Mount Lushan, has a Chinese name. Mei means beautiful, and Lu, apart from being the first character in the mountain's name, also means house. The characters were carved on a stone in Chiang Kai-shek's handwriting. Mei Lu Villa was built more than 100 years ago. It was presented to Song Mei Ling by a British lady. On August 8, 1933, Chiang Kai-shek and Song Mei Ling moved into the villa. There, they would spend one of the happiest periods of their life. In the 1930s and 1940s, Chiang and Song had to deal with a series of national and international crises. Mei Lu Villa was a haven from the pressure beyond the mountain. The couple grew very fond of the house. Chiang enjoyed his solitude, so he would read in the courtyard or gaze at the Yangtze River in the distance at the mountain's foot. Song, by contrast, enjoyed being the dazzling party hostess. The couple lived largely separate lives. Chiang followed a strict daily routine. He went to bed and got up early, but Song enjoyed the nightlife. They had separate bedrooms. Song had hers located on the ground floor to avoid waking Chiang at night. Chiang's own room was rearranged by Mao in 1959. Coming from very different family backgrounds, Chiang and Song had little in common. But their wedding was one of the biggest social events of the 1920s. It was said that the couple shared an interest in only politics, power, and fortune. In the year that they married, Chiang was 40 and Song was 30. The extravagance of their wedding caused a sensation in Shanghai. The yellowed photograph offers a glimpse behind the scenes of their marriage. Despite their differences, Song would play a vital role in Chiang's political career. Song became famous in the United States for her address to Congress in 1942, in which she charmed the lawmakers into granting U.S. aid to Chiang. After that success, Song took a keen interest in international affairs. She accompanied Chiang to the Cairo Conference in 1943, where they held discussions relating to the Second World War with Franklin Roosevelt and Winston Churchill. Time magazine named Chiang and Song among the 10 most influential couples in the world. Their holidays at Mei Lu Villa were an opportunity for the couple to relax together. Even after 70 years, visitors to the villa get a strong sense of the attachment the couple felt for it. Chiang Kai-shek was buried beside Lake Si in Taiwan in 1975. His friends and relatives harbored the hope that one day he would be moved to one of the three places he had chosen on China's mainland. On October 23, 2003, Song Meiling died in New York at the age of 106. Before her death, she had expressed a wish to be buried in her family cemetery in Shanghai and for Chiang's body to be moved to the mainland. Mei Lu Villa, with its lingering memories of historical figures, remains a silent witness to a bygone age.